Good afternoon, everyone. Myself Smruti Ranjan Jagadeb. I am pursuing my PhD in NIT Rourkela, Department of Electrical Engineering. Today I am going to present on this topic, performance analysis of IMC based PID controller for a twin rotor MIMO system. So these are my outlines: introduction, twin rotor MIMO system model description, objectives, model identification of TRMS and decoupler design for the TRMS, IMC based PID controller design, results and discussion, conclusion and reference. So introduction, twin rotor MIMO system. What is twin rotor MIMO system? Twin rotor MIMO system is basically a prototype model of a helicopter system. The aerodynamic modeling of helicopter system and twin rotor MIMO system are different. The aerodynamic model of helicopter system varies the angle of the rotor blade, whereas twin rotor MIMO system varies the speed of the DC motors. Actually, the modeling of the helicopter systems is very expensive and the designing is very complex. That's why many researchers have to choose this laboratory model setup for twin rotor MIMO system. So this is the laboratory model setup of twin rotor MIMO system, and this is the schematic block diagram of that TRMS. So the twin rotor MIMO system, basically the combination of mechanical unit and electrical unit. The mechanical unit of twin rotor MIMO system consists of two rotors. One is main rotor, another one is tail rotor. The main rotor can be controlled by varying the pitch angle, and the tail rotor can be controlled by varying the yaw angle. And both these rotors are connected to a beam at its on its two ends, which are driven by its two separate DC motors. And these rotors are counterbalanced by a pivoted beam, which is placed. With an appropriate weight, which are based on its base, that can move freely in any direction. Means the main rotor is moving like this, and the tail rotor is moving like this. The main rotor produces a lifting force to elevate the beam in an upward direction, and whereas the tail rotor changes the movement of the beam in horizontal direction. Apart from the mechanical unit, the electrical unit is placed under this tower. In electrical unit actually allows the measurement signal from this twin rotor MIMO system to the PC, and then this control signal via input PCL81 to input output card. The appropriate control signal is generated having the range of minus 2.5 volt to 2.5 volt. For the TRMS, the voltage given to the rotors are the input two input to the system, and the horizontal and vertical angle or pitch or yaw angle are the two output of the system. So these are the objectives: to develop an accurate dynamic model of the TRMS by employing system identification technique. Second is to design an appropriate dynamic decoupler to resolving the possible loop interaction between the input output of this multivariable system, and to develop a suitable robust PID controller with a decoupler to achieve improved control performance with disturbance rejection as well as set point tracking. So model identification of TRMS and decoupler design. Twin rotor MIMO system is a nonlinear system with a strong decoupling in between the rotors. So to keep the model identification more simple, we choose two linear rotor models with two linear coupling in between. So the model identification technique consists of four best fit model, two for main dynamics path and two for cross coupling path. So this is the schematic block diagram of two input two output system, or you can say twin rotor MIMO system. Here U1 U2 as the two input to the system, and Y1 Y2 are the output of the system. This is the pitch angle output, and this is the yaw angle output, and this is our plant, and these are the gains. Uh, The model identification of twin rotor MIMO system consists of four base speed models, two for main dynamic path and two for cross coupling path. The main dynamic path is from U1 to Y1. The corresponding gain is the main pitch gain G11, and U2 to Y2, the corresponding gain is G22, that is main yaw gain, and two cross coupling dynamic paths, that is U1 to Y2, the corresponding gain is cross pitch gain G21, and U2 to Y1, the corresponding gain is cross yaw gain. So actually twin rotor MIMO system is a nonlinear system. To linearize system using system identification technique, we have to use RMAX model. So in this table, the percentage fit of the data with various RMAX models are shown. These are the RMAX model for main pitch, these are the RMAX model for main yaw, and these are the RMAX model for cross pitch, and these are the RMAX model of cross yaw, and their corresponding percentage fit data are there. So from this table, the highest percentage fit value is the best, is the highest percent fit model is the precise model. So in this first column, this main pitch path among these five RMAX model, this has the highest percentage fit value, so we have taken this one as the best fit model. Similarly for main yaw, this one is the best fit, and for a cross pitch this one, and cross yaw this one. And corresponding to this best fit models, these are the output response which are compared with the actual open loop step response of main pitch path validation. In this figure A, and the red one is corresponding to this value, and the black one is the open loop step response of main pitch path. Similarly here, this model with actual cross pitch path, this one is the corresponding to this value, and cross yaw path, and this one is this model with main yaw path. Now these models are nonlinear, so to linear using this RMAX model, we have to linearize this. Then we convert this linearized model to continuous model. We use MATLAB function D2C command and reduced by using MATLAB function to get this transfer function. G11 is this, G21 is this, G12 is this, G2 is this. So our plant is this transformation matrix. Now decoupling controller design. The interaction between the manipulated variable and control variable deteriorate the performance of the system. That's why thus the interaction can be eliminated by designing a decoupler is required. So decoupling is classified into three categories: ideal decoupling, simplified decoupling, and inverted decoupling. Among these three decoupling, simplified decoupling is most commonly used technique, where the decoupler is in this format. Now in decoupler method, the plant PS requires the design of the transfer matrix DS in such a way that the PS DS must be a diagonal matrix. My PS is this one. PS is this one. If we multiply this with the decoupler, then our transform matrix is this one. In this case, the off diagonal are 0. That means the cross coupling is 0. So our TS is this transformation and this transformation. So this is the decoupling control structure of twin rotor MIMO system. This is our plant, and this is the decoupler part. The combination of these two is our TS. Now IMC based PID controller design. The IMC design procedure is exactly same as the open loop control design structure. Unlike open loop structure, the IMC structure compensates for both disturbance rejection and model uncertainty. This is the general structure of IMC configuration. Here QS is the IMC controller, GPS is the process which is unknown to us, and GP tilde S is the process model, YS is the process output, and y tilta s is the process model output, and d tilta s is the estimated disturbance, and ds is the disturbance. So in figure this one, this is the conventional configuration of feedback control system, which is identical to figure 7. If you take this block and by using block reduction technique apply, then we get this GCS, that is QS by 1 minus G tilta S into QS, where QS is the IMC controller, and QS equal to GP tilta inverse S into F dash S, where F dash S is the filter. Actually, the IMC controller requires a filter to make the controller at least semi proper. That's why this filter is required. And N is the order of the plant. Here N is the order of the plant, and the value of lambda is chosen between 1/3 to half times of the dominant time constant. The cascaded transfer function of the IMC controller is in this form. Now we arrange this equation 4 in the form of 5, and then find Kp, tau I and tau d, and using Kp, tau I, tau d, I have to find the PID parameters. So the plant PS, plant PS of the TRMS with decoupler DS is considered as the process model GP tilta S, is which is defined as this one. Means my equation 6 is same as equation 2. So for P channel, my GP tilta 1 S is this one. Here. So now my GP tilta S is this one, and GP2 tilta S is this one. Now GP1 tilta S is this one. Now we can write this in this form also. And for your channel, this equation is right in this form. The IMC based PID controller for pitch and your channel using transformation are GC1 is in for GC1 Q1S by, divided by 1 minus GP1 tilta S into Q1S. This is this one, and for your channel GC2 tilta S is this one. Now I am comparing equation 9 and 10. Now I am rearranging equation 9 and 10. In the form of equation 5, we get in this form for your channel, this is the equation. Now use the optimized value of lambda and then compare equation 11 and 12 with equation 5 to find the PID constant, which are as follows. So this is for pitch, these are the PID parameters. For your channel, these are the PID parameters. Result and discussion. So this is the simulation result. In this simulation results, we take a unit step signal as the reference signal. In this first figure, the proposed IMC based PID controller is compared with the conventional PID and the robust PID controller. In this case, the IMC based PID controller takes has less settling time than the other two PID controllers. In your channel also, IMC based has less settling time as compared to these two. Then in the in this next slide, we add 0.1 radian magnitude as disturbance signal at 35 seconds, and for to check the robustness of the system. In this case also, the IMC based PID controller exhibits better stable response than the other two PIDs. In this ear channel also same. And in this table, the settling time and ITA value, integrating time, absolute error value are shown. From this table, the IMC based PID controller has less settling time as well as ITA value for pitch channel and for ear channel. The IMC based PID controller has less settling time as well as ITA value. So this is my experimental results. Here I have to show the IMC based PID for set point tracking, and in the to check the robustness, I have to add a 0.1 radian disturbance signal at 35 seconds and check the robustness of the real time TRMS system. And these are the conclusion. IMC based PID control is proposed and applied to both pitch and ear channel of these. And the obtained results emphasize that the proposed IMC based PID control is more effective for set point tracking as well as disturbance attenuation, and a comparative assessment is also made in terms of integral time absolute error value and settling time value. These are the references. Thank you.